explain to our viewers that, remember, as the supposedly larger force, the only thing that will be acceptable for China, given its global ambitions, is an outright win. All India needs to do is defend strong. It's not as if India is looking to conquer Chinese territory. That's not the aim. India needs to hold, push back hard, and any stalemate is actually a comprehensive win for India. General Dwivedi, can you explain that? That it's not as if we need to go into China and capture their territory. All that we need to do is push the Chinese back really hard and defend strong.
Absolutely, Rahul. We need to defeat the Chinese design. The Chinese design is to change the line of active control and stay on put on the territory again. I want to make two points. Firstly, please, we underrate 1962 war. I think wherever we fought, we gave Chinese hand for money, whether it is Rasangla, and I was the division commander in Wolong. I can tell you that one third of the brigade sacrificed their lives and Chinese paid a very heavy price. So Chinese know that when we dig in our heels, we are a very, very strong opponent. First point. Second, very important point you have very rightly said, that we have to defeat Chinese design. If they come in, we can do the countervailing. We don't let them stay where they want to. We put pressure. We ask them to, force them to go back. I think we have achieved victory. And third, very important point, please remember, Chinese don't want to fight. It is not in interest of Xi Jinping actually to get into firefight.
Why not? Why do you say that?
Yeah, because Xi Jinping has two very important things coming up. In 2021 is the 100th anniversary of the Chinese party. And then 2022 is their 20th party congress. If the economy further balloons down, if the economy crumbles, Chinese Communist Party will not be able to hold itself in China. They'll be thrown out. So economically, Chinese cannot afford war because whole world will get after China. And they will like to actually have a face saving, to my mind. If we stick it out, the Chinese will then wriggle out. That is Chinese history. When they met a very strong opponent, they very gradually retracted.
Not just when they met a strong opponent, whenever, even if you look at Vietnam, whenever they've met an opponent, Sushant, who's fought back hard, they've never really come out strong. And that's been the checkered history of Chinese military going back decades.
Which is true. But see, I think it's not so much the Communist Party. I think it's about Xi Jinping himself. Imagine that if there is a reverse in...
Time when China, in any case, is facing some kind of global isolation.
They're getting into fights all over the place. This disquiet even within China, what does it do to this guy? On the flip side, however, if he is seen to be backing down from this particular confrontation, then how does that play out within the Chinese Communist Party and the different powers?
No, but when you speak about disquiet inside China, the reality is neither you nor I really know, given that big cyber iron wall, as it were. There may be simmering disquiet in dissent, but we don't really know for sure.
Rahul, the people who don't know what is happening, there are enough reasons to believe that there are murmurs of discontent. Obviously, in that system, nobody comes out as openly as you would in a democratic setup. But there are reasons and very serious reasons to believe that there is a restiveness even within the party, partly for domestic reasons, partly for other reasons. So for Xi Jinping, it's a loss of face if he does not take this forward. It's a loss of face if he takes it forward. So I think there's a kind of a commitment trap for him. Should you then give him a face saver? I don't think so. I think the time for face savers on both the Eastern and the Western front is over. We've given enough of those. So the Chinese will have to decide which way they want to roll the dice. And it's very risky for the Chinese, as the generals are saying, that if you fight them to a standstill or even don't rule out the possibility of actually making some gains on the ground, then where does it leave the Chinese? Where does it leave Xi Jinping? Where does it leave all this aura which the Chinese have built upon themselves? Listen, for God's sake, the 1971-79 war with Vietnam, they haven't been able to live it down even 40 years later. They still are, that war is remembered and it sends the shudder down the Chinese spine. as to what a tiny country like Vietnam did to them. So does the leadership at this point in time want this kind of a war? Yeah. I wouldn't entirely rule it out, but I won't even bet on it. So I think things hang pretty much in the middle, and it's a very dicey situation. Let's not take this lightly. This could roll any which way. I don't rule out the possibility of a conflict, but I think the Chinese would be stupid to enter into a conflict, because if they get a bloody nose, then all bets are off on what happens within China and what happens to this great Chinese aura and prestige which they've tried to build so assiduously all over the world over the last so many days.
But here's what we do know, that when the 1962 confrontation happened with the Chinese, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru didn't press every weapon system that we had in our arsenal. The Air Force could have been drawn into use very early in the conflict. Despite military advice, the Prime Minister at that time chose not to do so. What Prime Minister Narendra Modi has done today is signal that every single weapon system, whether it's military, diplomatic, will be used to try and ensure that we go back to status quo. That
Rahul, on sea and in air.
Oh, absolutely. And the fact that India is not comfortable with the current status quo and will push back hard. That message couldn't have been delivered more starkly. General Gurmeet Singh, General Dwivedi, Colonel Dini and Sushant Sarin for joining me and helping make sense of one of the most rousing speeches we've seen from any Indian political leader in living memory. Thank you very much. What we've seen today, make no mistake, is historic. The dragon has been stared back in the eye in a manner that the dragon didn't think was possible, the world didn't think was feasible. Prime Minister Narendra Modi coming back into his true form. Now, what happens next is a story we'll keep tracking very, very closely. We're heading into a break right now. Shiva Roor is up next with 5 Live. Stay with us. Hello, everyone. This is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.